It's a baby! What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slip Gator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things. I'm Magiga. Tempting fate. Hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. A lot of the guys were saying, XB was saying, it's pretty crazy that you keep your Giga in the base. They were scared. I feel like I'm pretty safe. I don't know. I'm hoping that we're safe. We'll see. We might build an external container for the Giga. But so we got the Giga in the last episode, hanging out with Drax. Was really having a good time. You guys loved the video. Thank you so much for smashing the likes button for me and showing your support and leaving all the nice comments. If you guys like this video, don't forget to hit the like button and show your support. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe for more ARK stuff and things. So we got the Giga. Last episode, we named it Giga, but I don't like that name very much. So I decided to name it a new name, a better name, and a fiercer name. A super fierce name that inspires fear in the fear place, brain place of any person who has fear ever. Brenda! Brenda the Super Giga! Look how cute she is! We're going to paint her later, and I think we're going to take her out too and do some leveling, and it's going to be scary. I can't wait to do it. But XB was telling me, you know, that he had a perfect tame T-Rex. And, you know, a couple episodes ago in the Dodo Rex battle, we lost Wi-Fi and Y-Tooth. And it was really sad. It was a really, really sad thing that happened. And I'm thinking we need to repopulate. We need at least one more Rex. And so what we're going to do today to start off the episode is we're going to bring Bluetooth over to XB's house. And I got to walk him over. So it's going to be cool. We'll have a little bit of an adventure, get over there. And once we're over there, we're going to get Y-Tooth in with XB's lady, T-Rex, and we're going to make him make a baby. We'll bring it back over here and we'll incubate, and then we'll do some other stuff and things. So much better of a growl howl than the Giga. But all right, so we got to get over to XB's place. I think it's like in a viscerally direction. All right, we're going to head over and then we'll BRB's, peeps. And we're back at XB's base. What's up, man?
Not much. Just hanging out, you know, rexing things.
Rexing things. So,
is this like the coolest looking Rex you've ever seen or what?
Well, I mean, Bluetooth is pretty amazing. But yes.
Yeah, but...
Is that the natural color?
Yeah.
Yeah, that is really nice. And it's perfect tame, right?
Yep.
Pretty unbelievable. And it's your lucky day, little lady.
Yeah, she's been clamoring about it all day.
She's been talking about it all day, some hot Bluetooth action.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
She was eyeing him from across the lake. And...
Oh, yeah? Look, she's sniffing his butt right now, just like dogs.
Yeah, she's... She's one of those, that's for sure.
So wait, we can't put him in your little room here.
Yeah, we can.
We'll have to...
He'll fit. Well, I mean, here, I'll get off. Oh, there you go.
All right. Oh, yeah, there we go.
Just walk him in, turn, like, hang an immediate right and walk him into the side.
All right, I'm going to hang immediate
right. They, like, never move.
I'm in the rock. I feel a little bit scared. All right, there we go. All right. Oh, she just pooped.
She's ready, man. She's making room.
Oh, my God. All right, I'm going to put them on Wander.
Right. Enable Wander.
Oh, there they go. They're doing it.
Yeah, and then they just walk into the wall there. It's pretty funny.
Oh, my God. Don't look, man. It's not polite to watch. You can't watch them.
Let's look this way.
Let's just look over here. So, anyway, how about that local sports team?
The Brontos are doing good this year, I think. I think they've just got a real shot.
The Brontos. The Megalodons.
It's the Poop City Brontos, right? Yeah.
Yeah, the Miami, the North Island.
Miami
Megalodons and the North Island
Carnes.
Gigantopithecus. That's a terrible name for a sports team.
Especially since there's no Gigantopithecus on the North Island.
That's right. That's the worst. The Volcano Megalodons. So are they doing it? They're about halfway done. Don't look. God. So gross.
I was trying to record it. You know, I mean, come on.
So
if it could work for Kim Kardashian.
Your head is so thin. I never noticed how thin your head is.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and yours is very, very thick.
Mine is pretty thick, and it's orange, too. I got an orange one right now. It's pretty great.
The Mazion and the Menace, right?
It stands for Mega... Mega.
Mega Mega?
Yeah.
Mega Mega Tiny?
Mega nice. Mega Tiny. This is my wrestler's... This is my wrestler's uniform for when I go wrestling.
Oh, like a luchador.
Yeah, exactly, man. I'm a luchador. I'm one of them. It's amazing. So nice. Are they going to squirt out a baby soon? They are. So I'm going to probably just take this back to my base and incubate it. Do you want to come over and see like the stats and what kind of baby we get out of this?
Yeah, I'd love to see what the baby is. Yeah.
We can see the baby. Oh, it squirted out a baby. Oh,
there it is. Grab it. Nice.
All right, I got it.
Get her out of your dino's way.
Oh, they're sleepy. Let's go ahead and just say wandering. I got him. All right, so now we got to walk back over to the base. Get in there, man. All right, nailed it. And we'll put the egg in my little incubation chamber and wait for it to become a baby, and we'll be our bees.
Mm-hmm.
And we're back, ladies and gentlemen.
Welcome back.
Oh! No! It's a baby!
It is definitely a baby.
I'm imprinting. What should we name
it? Nice. Oh, look at its color. Good. I don't know. I'm trying to think of like other kind of wireless things.
Got it. I got it. Hotspot.
Oh, nice. Perfect.
It's a lady, too.
Oh, that's even better.
We should probably give it food. Crap. Eat your food.
That usually helps.
Eat your food, baby. So, are you going to come out here, or are you going to be weird?
There it is.
Oh, it's so cute!
And it's got the colors of mom.
Is it?
Yeah. The red and black.
Let me see here. How come you can't whistle? There we go. I'm going to get it on follow so that when it goes through the maturation process and begins to wander, it does not wander away.
Then you can just disable wandering.
Well, each time, unless they fixed it, each time it changes maturation states, it re-enables wandering.
Mine never has.
It used to. Okay, maybe they fixed it while I was away. It used to. Like, they would go from baby to juvenile, and bam, it would start to wander again. So...
184, that's a pretty good level right there.
It's not bad. It's not bad at all, because perfect tame is one... What is it?
79.
179, right. So a couple extra levels. What kind of stats are we looking at here? 6,200 health, 1,400 stamina. That's really good stamina, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. 800 weight, 322% base melee damage. I've been wishing that this was a thing. I wish you could see, like, a breeding page for dinos that shows, like, what their base level was, what their tamed out level was, what their base stats were.
Yeah.
You know, like almost like a family tree type deal, because I think that would be really, really cool to help you keep track. Because right now you basically have to like either write a note and put it on there, or
As soon as you tame it, you have to put a note on it.
Yeah. So kind of a pain in the butt, but
at least you'll be able to increase your Rex population now.
Yeah. You're now, good. Well, now the inbreeding's still a thing though, right? So.
Hmm.
But I can still get really high-end tames, and it will be amazing and really, really cool. So that's awesome, man.
I was actually hoping it was a female so that you would have that option.
Now we can make a baby with a baby, and then that'll be... Mm-hmm. It'll be a little bit gross because it's this, you know, it's Bluetooth baby. So, but there's no incest in Dinosaur World.
Right.
Is there? Okay, good. All right, that makes it so much better. All right, well, cool, man. So it's going to take a while for this guy to grow up. I'm going to babysit it. I got some food in the trough over here, and I got some food on Bluetooth, and now we got Hotspot. It's going to be a thing.
Nice. Well, enjoy your new babby and all that.
All right, man, cool. Thank you very much for that. It's really, really, it's really nice. I really appreciate it. It's going to be awesome.
Yeah, no problem.
All right. Peace out, man.
All right. See you later.
And we're back. And all sorts of stuff and things are happening. No, I don't need to be in there. I need to be in here. So because I was gone and we've done some stuff and things, I noticed that we were like running really low on a bunch of different supplies. And so when XP took off, I figured while we were waiting for Hotspot to grow, I would just start getting some of the stuff and things done. So I had to like burn some wood up and make some charcoal and go and get some flint and then make some stone so I could make some gunpowder. And then I took that gunpowder and some metal and I turned it into bullets. And then I made those bullets and now I'm making those into 72. Oh yeah, baby. More tranquilizer darts, because we need them. We need tranquilizer darts. We're just running low on them, and we don't have any more. So we're going to make a bunch more tranquilizer darts over inside of here. I've already got a bunch more gunpowder being crafted, so it's really, really great, and everybody's happy about that because we can make more bullets, and more bullets means we can shoot more things, and shooting things is fun. So, all right, we'll make 56 more bullets as well. So now we've got a little stockpile of stuff and things. We're good to go with that. Let's check on Hotspot and see how she is doing. We'll pop down here. They definitely, as XP had said, change the amount of food that these guys eat. It's really quite nice. It used to be, like he was saying, you could almost couldn't feed them fast enough. I've been able to put some meat stacks on this lady here and just kind of sit around and not really worry about it now. It's been pretty good. She's not old enough to eat from the trough yet, I don't think. Actually, let's take a look. So if we take a look at her total weight, it's 800. Oh, yeah, she's eating from the trough. She is eating from the trough. So we can, because that's math, because math. So because 10% of 800 is 80. So once the weight right here becomes above 80, then she'll start eating from the trough. So actually, to be honest with you, what we should be doing is checking on the trough here and seeing and making sure we've got enough meat in there. So let's just squirt all this inside of there. Oh, yeah, it's like full. It's like full, for real full. So looks like that is all going good. So we're still waiting on Hotspot. She's so amazing and beautiful, but other stuff and things have happened in the game that, or in the update with the Giga Nodosaurus, and I wanted to play around with it. I haven't really looked at it yet, so let's take a look here in our Ingrams swords. Oh, baby! Nail the Ace that can't be stopped, and then shields. There's actually a couple different ones. There's a wooden shield. There's a riot shield, 35 Ingram points. Oh, I'm learning it. I don't care, whatever. This is going to be so cool. All right, so let's take a look here and see where we've got to get our sword made. Craftables, sword. Oh, what? So let's go into our Ingrams. I'm assuming maybe it's a smithy. I'm not sure. Or fabricator. Requires wooden club. We've got that. It doesn't say it needs to be made in any specific thing. So if we go into craftables, it's not there. Okay, so let us squirt up to the top here where we've got our smithy and see if that's where it has to be made. I'm assuming it is. And we can get the materials. Get out of the way! We can get the materials to get it made. All right, I'm so excited. There it is, right there. Nailed it, it's campus top. We already got all the stuff and things that we need. How much XP are we gonna get? Oh, we can't see because we're at max now. We're at level 89. All right, we've got it. Oh my God! So it says max durability 40, weapon damage 100. Again, because they use these percentages, we really have no idea what the relationship is to damage. If we go to the wiki, I'm sure we can find it out. Well, let's go ahead and just take a look here. I got a sword! Oh! It's very quiet. There's no whoosh noise, which is odd. Let's take a look at our sword. Oh, it's so cute! That's not a knife. For the Crocodile Dundee reference, check. All right, so we've got that. Now let's take a look at these shields. Craftables, that wooden shield, 40 wood. I don't even know if we're going to bother with a wooden shield. I mean, I guess we could build it just to see. So let's head down and take a look at that. Now, oh, before we do that, I'm betting that the metal shield is in the smithy and the riot shield is in the fabricator. Let us take a look here. So there's our metal shield right there. We need 20 cemented paste to make it, so we're very close. And then the riot shield, like I said, I'm guessing it's over inside of here. And that is, holy crap, 200 crystal, 120 polymer. 120 silica pearls. That's a lot of stuff and things. But I want to build it anyway. I think it'll be cool. Oh, we need some food. All right, let's head down here and take a look at this. You know what I'll do? I'll actually just build them all. I'll build the wooden shield, I'll build the metal shield, and I'll build the riot shield, and then we will BRB's peeps. And we're back with our amazing sword. And I had some statistical information to give you. Remember I was saying in the last clip there that we can't really tell how much weapon damage does what, and we kind of can because the wiki has that information. So a pike's base damage, even though it says 130%, is 55, and then the sword's base damage is 90. So, but here you can see this is a print of a sword we've just made from Engram, so the weapon damage is just a straight 100%. With the 130% from the apprentice pike, that takes the, let me do the math here, 55 times, 72-ish? So if you take 55 and multiply it by 1.3, you're going to get around 72 damage. So the base primitive sword has a, it's supposed to have a better damage amount than the pike. So as far as like how the sword works, I haven't really used it yet, so I'm not really sure. Like, well, the pike, you know what I mean? You get a little bit more distance. I'm not sure if there's like a distance thing or how this works. So we're going to take it out and we're going to try it out. But then I wanted to talk about the shield a little bit. And from what I was taking a look at, it looks like these are basically just durability and weight. So I don't know how the shield exactly works. And again, we're going to play around with that here in a little bit. But I don't think there's like a difference in like an armor level that I could see on the wiki. So this, you've got 15 weight for 250 durability. This primitive metal shield is 45 weight for 720 durability. And then this thing, 30 weight, so lower weight for the primitive riot shield, 1400 durability. And I mean, it's pretty cool. It's super expensive. So, all right, let's take a look. We just go like that. Oh, we got a shield. Oh, it's a shield. What does it look like? It looks kind of wimpy. It's just made of wood, so it's a little bit of a wimpy shield. Oh, if we right click, we get a shield thing happening. Come at me, bro. Come at me, bro. Oh, you want to go, Dimorphodon? Oh, this thing sucks. I couldn't get a hit on him at all. Come here. Oh, I hit him. He's a level 64. I'm hurting him. I'm hurting him. Oh, I got him. Oh, yeah. Peace out. Get sorted. He just got pieced out. That wasn't that bad. We killed a 64 Dimorphodon with just a few hits of the sword. And I think that was a lot better than using a pike. All right, cool. So let's take a look at the metal shield. Oh, baby, you can see through it. Oh, that looks awesome on the back. That's so cool looking. So does it change like our run speed or anything? No. Can we run? So you can't run and have your shield up at the same time, but you can walk. It kind of looks, that looks funny. So if you just walk like this, it looks totally normal. If this is the block and walk. Hey, what's up, man? All right, so this thing looks pretty cool. I like that quite a bit. All right, so we got the metal shield now. Let's check out the big boy and see. Oh, yeah, baby, completely. Oh, this is so cool. That looks rad. Is the walk still kind of derpy? Yeah, it is. It's a little bit derpy. It'll probably get fixed up. That's really neat. You can just see right through it. It's nice that it doesn't really screw with your durability, well, that much. It's kind of dirty. Hopefully, they'll come out with like a Windex Engram and Paper Tiles Engram or something like that, because that's a little bit hard to see through. So, all right, so then the next thing I guess we would want to find out is, can you dye these bad boys? Let's go inside of Stuff's inventory here and see. And we're back with our new super shield. Boy, this thing looks cool. It would be so neat if we could like mount that on a wall or something. That looks really, really cool. There's a lot of detail on this metal shield. It looks great. It's really, really cool. So I dyed that one. Here's what the wooden shield looks like dyed. I just kind of dyed it up. Oh, there's some funky stuff going on there. It looks kind of neat. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look. You can see it's kind of like a splattery paint job on it. It's good because it's a starter shield type thing. And then if we take a look at the ride shield, you can dye this guy too. And so I got some different colors on it right there. So that's pretty cool. And I'm thinking like that I would use this a lot. Like, I feel like my pike is pretty much going to go away, and this is going to be the combo that we use. I'm going to drop off those shields inside of there just because it's really heavy. And let's go ahead and drop these back on to Ouncy. Let's pop out over here really quickly. Hopefully we can find something to use our sword and shield on. Is there anything aggressive in the area? I want to just try to, like, take on something dumb. No, of course not. Oh, there's a Carno. There's a Carno right there. What level are you, Carno? 20. All right, let's do this. Come here. Bring it on, Carno. You want some? I got my shield. I'm not even taking damage. No way. I'm killing him. Oh, baby. Tink. Tink. That's awesome. So if you were like in a really terrible situation, you could just run your shield up and then just kind of back away and back away. That would be great. Now, can you use it? Oh, you can use it while you're harvesting? No way. That's so cool. So you can just kind of have it out all the time. And if you get in trouble, you could, like, be backing off to go back to your dino or something like that. That's really neat. I like the shield thing. I think it's pretty cool. All right, so we got our shields. Really cool new items. I think we've got to check on Hotspot, and I think it's time for us to have a little one-on-one time with Brenda. So we're going to have to paint her. We got to paint Brenda and give her a good paint job. You know, the only thing is that shield's going to get kind of annoying in your face there. But all right, so we'll take it off. But Hotspot's doing good. We're at that 10% level. What's up, Brenda? You want to get hot? We're going to give her a hot paint job, peeps. Let's do it. Now we're back, and guys, I'm really, really excited. Look what I found. Mastercraft metal hatchet. I can't believe it. I've never found a Mastercraft anything before. I got it off a Raptor. I was killing a bunch of different stuff on Bluetooth while I was just out around doing stuff and things. I got a Apprentice Crossbow, Dreamer Crossbow, whatever, Ramshackle Metal Pick, whatever, Mastercraft Metal Hatchet, durability 112, weapon damage 176. Let's take a look over here at our regular hatchet, 92. Wow, that's a huge difference, man, from our Apprentice Metal Hatchet. Now, you may notice, first of all, that Brenda's looking pretty hot. Now, I think that we're going to start doing all of our ladies in white and then all of our dudes in blue because I really like the color scheme. So that's what we're going to do. I look pretty amazing as well. Just wanted to say it. But I've taken off all my stuff and things except for I think I'm going to bring. No, I don't really need water. I think I'm just going to bring food. That's it because I'm afraid that she might turn on me. I've never done this before. So we have her on neutral so that she will attack other things. So say, for instance, wow, that she moves fast. That's crazy. So say she, like, turns on me and kills me, and then I'm out in the, you know, she's out in the middle of nowhere by herself. She'll at least, well, I don't think anything would kill her anyway by the time I got back to her. But at least this way, you know what I mean? Like, she'll defend herself. So let's just go ahead. We're just going to slowly walk up over here to this Parasaur. Killed it. Now that he's the KB stopped. This is going pretty good. Stamina's looking pretty good. Let's just motor over here. Paraceratherium! Dead in one bite. Crazy power. Crazy power. Still kind of can't get over rocks like a T-Rex. But I want to try to take her out to the North Island. Gosh, she does move fast. But her stamina? Oh, that's so rough. That's so rough, man. What's up, little... Raptor, you're dead, man. Peace out, Raptor. That stamina amount is really, really rough. So, how long does it take to recharge? Oh my god. Yeah, it just really is too bad, man. Like, it makes it so that just not an effective dino to use. Like, they just, I mean, maybe a higher level one would be, but I don't think besides this time that I take her out to play around, I don't think I would use it very much because it's going to be such a pain in the butt to wait for its stamina to recharge all the time. Holy crap, though. See, the thing is, I can see on a PvP server where this would be very effective because what you could do, you know what I mean, is in PvP, it's a whole different story. You'd want to slowly, and it would take you a long time to bring them to somebody else's base. And then once you had them over at their base, they'd be a really effective siege tool, but you got to be really careful because of the stamina. So for the PvP, I feel like I can see that it's very balanced. For PvE, like we have on our server, it's not quite, you know, it makes it so that we wouldn't really use them very much, but you got to have that balance. That's important. So, all right, it's going to take me a while to get her out to the North Island, but I'm going to do it and I will BRBs, peeps. And we're back. All right, we're going to see if this is going to work. Can we get on there? Oh, baby. Ah! We're on. We got the Giga on. Is this going to be a thing? Are we really taking a Giga? Oh my god. Hold on. Let's zoom out as much as we can. That's as far as I can get zoomed out. We can't even see the whole Giga. It's so humongous. It's crazy, man. Look at her. She's fearless. She's got no fear. She's not even afraid. Being on the Northern Island, it's unbelievable. I tried swimming with it too, just so you guys know, and it was really, really, look at it. It's doing like moonwalk. It was really, really slow to swim, like ridiculously slow to swim, which is as you'd expect, but it was just kind of interesting to see. All right, so we're almost over here. There's a red drop coming down over there, so we could definitely go and get that. And I did get a level, or two actually, I can't remember now. I think it was just one. So I did get a level. Let me go ahead and take a look here. And we got melee damage up to 165. The stamina thing, because they do kind of move so fast just by walking, it's not really necessarily a super big problem. I figure it'll just be like a thing where we don't really use that much stamina. Also, for some reason, there we go. My HUD was gone. All right. So I think it's time. Is that a purple? I think it's a purple. I thought it was a red, but it's not. Where's it? Where'd you go, Scorpion? There you are. Meet your inevitable demise. This is unbelievable. How much? Oh, you want some? Oh, you're dead. Is this a level 16 Carno? Scorpion. 38 chitin for one scorpion. Crazy, man. Oh, man. 104 Raptor took one. All right. I think it's time for a levely up montage, peeps. Here we go. Let's do it. And we're back at home base with Brenda, who I think we're going to rename. Somebody on Twitter, and I can't remember who, tweeted at me a really good name. And I don't know if anybody's used this name or not, but I think it's really, really great, and I want to do it. So even though I think Brenda's hilarious, we have to change the name. Last time, name change. Gigabyte. Gigabyte is a thing, peeps! And you know what? Also, there's all sorts of people who are like being pronunciation Nazis about this, the name of this dino. And I found from a couple of different places that I was looking up pronunciations for it. And it looks like that it's hard to say if it's Giganotosaurus or Giganotosaurus. It's hard to say. I think the Oxford Dictionary says it's Giganotosaurus. But I think some other places were saying it's Giganotosaurus. So I like Gigabyte or Gigabyte. Gigabyte's super funny as well. And we leveled her up a little bit, and she's looking really good on stats. Also, we didn't take any damage at all the entire time. We have 210 melee damage now. We didn't take any damage at all. And with her being on passive, on neutral, I may regret this, but I am not worried about, famous last words, I'm not really worried about having it in my base. Like, I just don't think it's going to be a big deal because it doesn't really matter what it is that attacks her. As long as she's on neutral, she's going to attack it back and she's going to kill it in one hit. So I don't see any way where she's going to lose enough hit points that it's going to be an issue. We may go ahead and build some more stone gates and just make a gated in area right here just in case. I guess she could probably take the stone gates out pretty quick. And I'm not sure how long a rage lasts, but like I said, I feel pretty confident that it's not going to be a big deal, in this area right here. She's going to just attack anything. So, all right, over here. Oh, wow. We've taken all the damage. We got the juvenile hotspot. Let's take a look at how our food's doing. We got plenty of food here. Oh, also check out what we got from our run in the North Island there. Huge amount of chitin from that run. Oh, and also, did I say what level she is now? 57. So she's doing really, really good. So we got all that stuff. Really, really excited about the new dino. I love it. I can totally see why it is the way it is. I feel like it is very, very balanced, especially in the PvP environment. I think that's where the big, big balance comes into play. So we're going to squirt this stuff back into our chest here. And, you know, one of the things that we never did is we never had a funeral ceremony for our Rexes, and I feel like that's something that we've got to do. So I think it's time. Everybody go ahead and put on your best suit. We have to put Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, to rest in our dino graveyard. BRBs. And we're back. Laying to rest. What? We're trying to lay people to rest. Now you're laid to rest. Laying to rest. Our most revered and amazing dinos. Y-Tooth, Wi-Fi, and Ingot, who all passed away fighting the Dodorexin and then also just being killed by RGs. Set sign text, rest in peace. Wi-Fi, you will be missed, great and powerful dino. Rest in peace, Y-Tooth. You will be missed, Lady Dude Sun Daughter of Powerful Dinos. And rest in peace, Ingot. You had an awesome name and a great paint job, but you got killed by an RG, and it was over for you. And there we have it. The Dino Graveyard grows, but so do our adventures! So excited. Thank you guys so much for coming to hang out with me today. If you guys like this video, please don't forget to show your support and smash the like button. Ugh. Feel free to share and favorite the video as you see fit. May the stuff and things be with you.
Bye, guys. I love you.
All right, it's time to go make bullets.